favorite because there's no gifts. You can just have all your food and family and friends, and that's what makes it so fabulous. I'm so glad to see you all here today, and I've said this to you over and over again. Your job is so important. It is so important. What you are doing with Ann is helping every teacher in your school, every principal, to see the importance of technology, to help the students to learn almost in a different way, and to help the teachers teach in a different way. But if they don't have that coaching, if they don't have that person in the school that they can say, oh, I know I can rely on, if I have a problem, I can do this, then they're not going to go ahead and do it. So I just applaud you and say, continue all the fine work. I'm going to anyone Ann's time.
So what I did, it's the usual sheet of what we're talking about today. But just to go over it so that you see when we get to it, there's a sheet that says active listening on the front. And one of the things that we're going to start practicing, and it's going to be over the next however many months and years and decades of education. But what we want to do is we want to start practicing a little bit of those coaching skills. And so I know that a lot of people talk about having a little bit of difficulty how to, you know, talk to people and to help them through things. We're going to start with that. And on the back, I decided that it might be helpful to start giving us a little outline of kind of what we're trying to do in a particular session and about how much time we're going to spend on different things. Because I know that it can feel like we're, you know, just at a tear going forward, but it's good to see about how much time we're going to be spending on different things. And the ones that I italicized are the ones where we're going to have either whole group talking or one-on-one or in smaller groups, so that, again, you can kind of see how we're weaving in the time where you can get some time to share with one another what's going on, ask each other, you know, what ideas you have. So I'm gonna try to do this for the next few workshops we do together and see if it ends up being useful to you or, you know, it doesn't even matter. Then one of the big parts of MEET that we're doing today is talking about copyright-friendly images and fair use. And this is a sheet that I found online that you can use with your students or just for yourself to begin having an outline for yourself of, is what I'm doing fair use of images or sound or whatever. Okay, so let us, as we always do, start with a prayer. And it's on the back of our 3-2-1 sheet. So I'd like us all to just take a minute to take a breath. Together we'll bless ourselves and pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ has
no body but ours, no hands, no feet on earth but ours. Ours are the eyes through which he looks with compassion on the world. Ours are the feet with which he walks about to do good. Ours are the hands with which he blesses all the world. Amen.
I'm always trying when we work together to give you some different ideas of how to work with the grown-ups as well as how to work with the kids. And last month, we did a little introduction with a big rock, paper, scissors game. And again, the idea was to break the ice a little bit for the people who were new to the technology integration workshops. And again, just to give you a different idea, I mean, this could be an interesting thing for Catholic Schools Week to have a massive rock, paper, scissors with these kids. So just different ideas. But today what I'd like to do is I'd like to do something called speed dating. Has anybody ever done that as a technique to talk to people outside of dating? Okay, so the idea behind speed dating is it gives you a short 2 minutes to talk to somebody around a topic. And so what we're going to do is we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Okay, so I won't stand in one, but we're going to make two lines. So Donna and Anna, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7, actually, 2, 4, 6, 7. So Chaz and Anna are going to kind of walk straight down, and everybody's going to walk and follow them. And you're going to pair up two people together. And then I'm going to ask you to, and you may know each other already because we've certainly gotten together enough times. I'm going to ask you to just introduce yourself if you've never met before. Hi, I'm Anna Rowe from the Archdiocese Center. And then you're going to tell them, you know what, one of the expertises I have is, so if you need to know a little bit about, I'm pretty good at that, I'd be happy to talk to you. You know, you might have an expertise in helping little kids get used to using the mouse. You might have an expertise in helping students do research for papers, or helping students learn math a different way using the computer, or, you know, creating PowerPoints or whatever, program, whatever it is that's your expertise. So, I would probably say, you know, hi, my name's Ann Oram, I work at the Archdiocese Center, and I really became an expert in having kids work on collaborative projects. And then I would be talking for about a minute. I would tell you a little bit about, you know, one of my favorite projects was a progressive story. We had four schools together, and each school took a turn writing one paragraph, and by the end, the four schools had built a whole story together. So I would tell you a little bit about that. And then the other person would say, oh, hi, my name's Elizabeth DeWitt, and I work at, you know, and tell a little bit. So that way, by the end of 10 minutes, you'll have talked to five different people, hear a little bit about what somebody feels like they're a bit of an expert in, and be able to share your expertise. And then after we do that, we'll sit down and do our big networking like we always do. Chaz was gracious enough to bring a device that you may have heard about last month if you were in his workshop. He has a device that you can put an iPad on so that it becomes a document camera. And Elizabeth brought a thing called Air Server that she's going to tell us about, which allows you to project your iPad on a screen. And so she's going to tell us all about that. And then, of course, whatever else we want to talk about for that half hour. So let's get ourselves in two lines, and what I'll do is once we get ourselves matched up, I'll set the timer for 2 minutes, and then we'll do, like I said, five rotations.